Hi guys, Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I'm coming out of hibernation for a short little video, show you what I'm doing today. This has to do with seed saving. I started my seeds, and normally they would be in the greenhouse by now, but Mother Nature is not cooperating with us.
We are getting sunshine today to melt all this white stuff, but we're not done with winter yet. Normally we are. The trees usually have buds on them. I'm thankful they don't because they would have been zapped and no fruit trees, or no fruit anyway. So anyway, we're just having a very late spring this year. And that's why I'm doing my little transplanting over there.
So normally these guys would be out in the greenhouse, but because they're not going to be, I have to do some transplanting. So I'm going from these little cups that I started them in to these bigger cups. And these are tomatoes, so they're gonna hopefully take this transplant really well, because you know, when you plant them in the ground, you go up to the first, or beyond, right up to that first set of leaves, so it's not such a big deal. But the thing I wanna talk to you about is, if you're saving seeds, or you have a seed stash, which we all do, don't throw those old seeds out, because, I just wanna show you this. See, that says 2010 Brandywine? Well, that means these seeds are from 2010. Yeah, they're 8-year-old seeds. And these are Rutgers. Okay, these are Rutger tomatoes, 2012. And I planted them heavy, thinking, well, they're old seeds, so they won't sprout. Yes, they will. This is going to be a fun one to transplant. And I'm going down to one plant, of course. But lots of them came up, so I really didn't need to do that as heavy as I did. But there again, it depends on the seed. Like parsnips, you aren't going to keep those much beyond 2 years. But tomato seeds, for example, yeah, they can be really old and still sprout. And I had the same thing happen with my broccoli and my cauliflower. Old seed, about same age, they came up like gangbusters. So your brassicas, your tomatoes, pepper seeds are fussy. But anyway, yeah. So if you've got a seed stash and you're going through it and you're saying, oh, these are 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, don't toss them. You will probably still get viable plants from them. Okay, just wanted to share that. And I have to get back to work because I have many more flats to go. Come on, spring. While I'm doing my repotting project, a few years ago, I had to repot all my brassicas because I had them in my little rolling greenhouse and I had them rolled out for the day to get sunshine. The wind came up, blew them over, and I was trying to salvage them. And this is when I discovered you could do this. But just like with tomatoes, when you're repotting tomatoes and you pot them deep, or you plant them deep up to that first set of leaves, you can do that with your brassicas. If you are starting seeds in the house, and because it's a late spring or whatever, you got a late start maybe, or too early of a start, and they start getting spindly and they have these little skinny stems that you know aren't gonna do you any good, you can repot those right up to the leaves, like I did these. Or if you're putting them in the ground, you can do the same thing and cover those little spindly stems up and you'll be fine, good to go. So just a little tip. I figured out why two of these are so overloaded. These are my pig tomatoes. Remember from a few years back, I had tomatoes that came up in the old pig pen, and they were the most delicious little cherry tomatoes I'd ever had, so I saved seeds and I've been growing them ever since. So these seeds were only 2 years old, and I was in planting heavy mode and forgot that they were younger seeds. So I'm gonna see if I can save more than just one out of each cup. But, oh, I love these little tomatoes. I think they might be super sweet 100s. But someone told me those were hybrids, so I don't know, because they are breeding true. This will be the third or fourth year I've had them. But anyway, so, but we're getting there.